Hi, all you SPMEs out there. Today's question has three answers, and the third answer is a secret as to what it will take for you to become a self-publishing success story. Now, let's get into it. The question that was sent in to me today was, Amazon Kindle self-publishing success stories? Now, the reason the person asked this question is clearly because they're wondering whether or not it is possible to do really well and succeed at Kindle self-publishing. Maybe you've written a book, or maybe you're considering writing a book, and you're thinking maybe Kindle's the right place for you, but can you actually succeed? Is it possible to win at this game of Kindle self-publishing? And that is what I'm going to answer today. This is Chris Baird from selfpublishingmadeeasy.com, where self-publishing doesn't have to be so hard. Click the subscribe button if you'd like for me to make more videos like this one, and check out below in the description and you will see my absolutely free self-publishing checklist to help you get started at optimizing your books. And also, if you've even put books out there, finding maybe perhaps the tools you're using are not the best tools you should be using on your self-publishing journey. So, Amazon Kindle self-publishing success stories? Well, let me tell you a little bit about my story. When I first got started, I started because I had been reading some of the writings of Steve Scott, and as a big self-publisher himself and a person writing books on habits and such, I saw it very motivational, and I saw that, wait, you can get your ideas out there. He didn't have a degree in writing on habits and all of these sorts of things. And so it initially got me started into the game. Now, I wasn't actually familiar with how big of success some people could have, but just the idea of putting books out there, I found that to be very tempting for me to actually jump in on that exact game. And so I put my first book out there, and I did not become a success with regards to that one. But over a period of time, I began to learn the tips and tricks that were necessary to start getting your books to not only sell, but sell a lot of copies, some of them as much as 1,000 copies on a single book. And what exactly is necessary to do that? Well, I was within forums and groups, and I watched videos, and it was very confusing, and it was difficult to completely understand. And that's one of the reasons I even created this very channel, was to help break it down and to try to simplify the process to succeeding and making a killing at Amazon self-publishing, especially with the Kindle. And over a period of time, I began to see how exactly certain books I was putting out were making a killing, and others were doing okay. And sometimes there was patterns that emerged among the ones that were and the ones that weren't. And during this process, I was also, of course, in contact with other people who were making a complete killing on just a few books. Sometimes as few as just 1 to 3 books was enough to do it. So Amazon Kindle self-publishing success stories. Well, I can tell you a couple self-success stories. One of them was somebody who's a friend of mine who, over a period of years, also was following some of the same strategies and ended up getting, I think it was December a few years back, hit $40,000 in a single month selling books on Minecraft. Now, the one downside, of course, is that Minecraft is a protected thing, and Microsoft protected it, so eventually those books had an issue. But during that period of time, there was it was a huge amount of money that was flowing through in a single month to these books that were coming through. Now, keep in mind, it wasn't just Kindle, because you will lose if you only are doing it on Kindle, but he also was putting on the paperback and in different formats so that people could very easily listen and read those books. The second one comes back to Steve Scott's books on habit formation. He had a whole series of books on habits, and he had hit a $60,000 month. And that was actually maybe one of the main reasons that got me involved in self-publishing, was the understanding that you could write books on things that you're interested in and see those sales come through to your books. Now, this is a very important point that many people miss. It's the idea that if you aren't in contact with people who are succeeding at what you're trying to succeed at, you can become quickly demotivated. And virtually 80-90% of the entire thing is a head game. It's all about staying motivated, staying in touch with the people who are succeeding at what you wish to succeed at. And then the final step is continually doing that very activity over and over, which is kind of funny because a book on habit development, of course, is actually focusing on exactly how you build these habits in there, because if you stick in there long enough, you will eventually win. If you're trying the right strategies and you're doing it over and over, you go a long enough period of time, you'll win. For me, it was self-publishing. That was what gave me my win. But you know, maybe there's other categories, but if you stick in there long enough, you will be able to succeed. But that brings us to the secret answer of the day, and that answer is, you don't have to be a big winner. In other words, you don't have to be a success story of that one book you wrote that was just amazing. The key is, if you have a lot of books and each book gets better than the previous one, you're optimizing those books based upon writing to markets that are hungry. You're making a great cover and title, and the description are fantastic. Then you've got it formatted correctly. I use a tool called Jutoh. You can check out my affiliate link in the description. Fantastic tool for making sure the format's correct. And then you're running ads against those books and marketing them and putting them into all the different markets and such. You'll be getting sales on each of those books. Now, then how many books? Well, you just keep on putting out more books. The more books you put out, the more money you will make. And the oldest books that you put out will continue selling if you're in the correct market. So this is something you're really going to want to consider doing if you're jumping into the self-publishing game. And it is a game. Like any other game, there are strategies, and you're going to want to follow those in order to become a success story yourself. So, Amazon Kindle self-publishing success stories. What have you found? Do you know anybody who's been a success at Amazon? Or maybe you yourself have. Let me know below in the comments. I respond to all of the comments that come in, and check up above me here for more video answers to your self-publishing questions. Thanks.